right, guys. Good day. Another good day to you. I've not had many tutorials. Good day. God bless you for joining me. Today we're gonna do an image upload button. It's gonna use the input type button, but this time we're gonna style it. We're gonna hide it and show our very own styled version of it. That's what this tutorial is about. It also shows you if your upload system is not working because they're showing you C fake path, the C with a column and the double slash and then the fake path, then you could, if you've not yet found the solution like I have gotten access to the solution by God's grace, then you will see it here. If it's not this video, in the next one. Right, so first we're gonna do the button and then next we're gonna do that one. We're gonna upload it using JavaScript that way, binary or string. So I'm creating a new file. I think you know how to create a new HTML file. I'm gonna use Notepad because Alright, so we do the head, then we close the head tag, and then we do the body. Okay, then we close the body tag. Alright, and do the form, and then we close the form file. Then we say, hey, I'm gonna style this thing, hide it. So we are gonna style it, hide. But we put it right here. Formatted post. I don't know what it is. Okay, formatted post. Okay. Maybe you might. This is new content of PhD. Maybe you might do PhD. So formatted post. And then we have the first div that will contain. You can see I put in a div. I will do this for you to see. And then I'll do it again. This is the first one where we put our fake body, and this is the second one where we have the input type, right? We have the input type here, and so this one we have the button, and I like styling the button as li for okay, I will style it as a because I don't want to go to the wrong way of styling, and I will put in the, and I will come down here and I will put in the input type, which is what it's underlining it. This is what this is what normally we would have wanted to do. Do the ID, which is also a file. I call a file. Not the ID is accessible in JavaScript. The name is accessible in PHP. I shouldn't do the name here, but I did it. And then the onChain function, we're going to use it later to assist to upload the file in JavaScript. That's if you know what you mean. So we say upload file or get file. We pass in the event in there and then we close it. Alright, so thank God it's left with nothing. Alright, this is just what I want to show you. So this guy will be styled as a okay, before I keep styling, I want to show you this thing. This thing is on my server. I have a server. It's HTTP/warm store. So I just open Mozilla. Forgive for not opening before. This was supposed to be a long, very short tutorial. Alright, here we go. Localhost, I think I'm in a folder called upload. And the file is called test. I don't know if it's test or test. Here it is. It's test. HTML, I don't know if it's just, there we go. You can see the joke is right here. I hope it doesn't work, right? This is what you want. You want to click the button, but you don't want this thing. You want it to be like YouTube has it, Google has it, then, but when you open it and it's able to upload a file like this guy, open this modal and work with it. That's what we're gonna do. So this guy's gonna be beneath it, and then you're going to work with it. So here it is, the style is going to be position position, relative, and then every guy, everybody is going to be in it. And then I will have to do something. I will have to put in, let me use the method. I will put in the, here, native, so that I can do a flexbox, right? I love flexbox. I will do a flexbox. You know what I will do? I will take everything and put it in the middle. Alright, I don't think that's necessary. And in order for you to see distance, position, relative, and I want to position each of these guys in absolute. Before that, I've showed you, I'm in a rush. I will start this thing. This will be, this guy will be on top of this guy, and this guy will be completely transparent. This guy will be transparent, and this guy will be on top of this guy. So I would say, upload, right? And I come here, refresh it. You can see the upload is showing on top. I will style it a little bit. I will style it with background colors. And when you start styling like this, then you can do whatever you want to do with it. Okay, so sorry for delaying your time. At least what I wanted to do. And then the width and height should be taken care of by this guy. The width will be 100 pixel. I don't know if it's 125 pixel by 75 pixel. That should be the height. Okay, here we go. Alright, so that's the guy. You can see everybody's in there now. Except for this guy who's floating up. I will teach it a lesson very soon. So I will style it. I will style this guy and give it a width of 100% so that it doesn't float upside. So that it obeys me 100%. You can see it's floating in the 100%. So that we can see whatever we are doing. I will shift this guy to background color. I don't know what to use. I will say gold. Right, I want to say gold. There you can see these are different. Every one of these guys, the hidden, the width and the height. We will make these two the width and the height. But here we go. I will position these guys. So the most important thing now, the position. You can see this is relative. So every position will be inside. Only if the position will either be relative or absolute. In this case, it has to be absolute. Here we go. Position absolute. I won't change mine for now, but I will see it right now. Alright, so position absolute, because it has been position absolute, this guy has not positioned it. It has already clinged itself to the borders. I will cling it 100-100 very soon. But before that, I will position. Let me set this top to 0, this bottom to 0. Right, it's left to 0, and it's right also to 0, so it stays wherever I want it. Oh, see, it has flooded it. Now this guy is on top. I don't want it to be on top. I want it to be beneath. Now this guy will have to be beneath. I will style it. I will give it a style. I will do this. I think I will have to change this guy's position. Take it up. I will finish right now. Position absolute. There. Now, same nonsense. Top 0. So you say, what? Wait a minute. Isn't that wrong? Okay. Top 0, bottom 0. I think it's going to flow. Oh, yeah. You can see it has come on top. And then the other guy is being. Now, if I click this thing, it's opening, but if I click here, it's not open. If I click here, that will be fixed very soon. Bottom 0, left 0, just so the code doesn't, already people are seeing where this is going. And then I will make it really high, like, should I say 100% or should I put it there? I will put it there. You can experiment with 100% nonsense. I think 100% work, but I don't have time. I just jump. I really wanted to make the story as good for them. Okay, this guy is not really working for my 100%. I will find out why it's not doing my 100%. I think it's here. I'll have to get the height to 100%. grip this. If it doesn't work, good. Look, it's giving the 100%. Now, if I click the corner here, if I click the corner here, oh, everywhere I click, it's working. The code is working. But I need this guy to remain on top, but invincible. So the people think they are clicking the upload button. My own self-made upload button. Pretty naturally, they're clicking this thing because this thing is invincible to them. So I will start it like if correctly guessed it. Style invincible. So here it is. I'm giving this background color. I forgot it. I think we used to say background color of transparency or visibility or it's opacity. Opacity zero. If opacity zero, boom, it's missing. Now it's there, but it's missing wherever I click, and now I can have my own button because the style is terrible. I will style it right now. There you can see it's there, it's not there. Here, where's the input type? Here's the input type. It's there. Here it is. Every function is also there. But hey, you know that we could have gone out to style it. Like, we could have gone out to style this guy then too, so that the display will be flesh, and then we display flesh, and then we say align, and say justify content center, and I will love the align self here, because it's just one. I will love the align self here, and I will say center, and then the whole button will be in the center. But like I said, we don't have the time. You can style it for yourself, even for the whole thing. This is supposed to be my flesh, but let's say display flesh, and I'll do the same thing, justify content. Oh, here we go. Okay, and I'll say align content, align items. I say align item center. You know that the justify content is for horizontal alignment, and the my justify content is not working because the styling is not there. If I have to put the styling there, if I don't put the styling there, my vertical align, which in this case is align items, will not work. You know that this part, the align, the flesh was working because the container has a height. So we have to give a height here for the HTML on the body. And the height is, like you guessed it, is from the W3C's advice. It's 100%. Right? It's 33. Hurry, I think that makes it a big deal. Oh boy, it's not working. My display first align center, align items, it's not working. I will change it right now to align content. Maybe I got it wrong. It's supposed to be align content. Oh, it didn't work. What am I going to do? What a shame. I'm live on YouTube and what I'm doing is not working. Oh God. What am I going to... I think the problem is from this guy, not from this guy. I think I'll have to give the styling here and give it away to 100%. How can you disgrace me so much? A height of 100%. And here we go. Oh boy! I will say something around 100%. What did I say? 500%. 5,000 pixels, which is way bigger than my screen. Oh, but it didn't work. What am I going to do? What a shame in life. If I could find only one error, maybe I explore the height one. Which is not happening to anything wrong. I will check the console. What's wrong with my style? I like content. Fuck you. Sorry. I don't know. Align items, that's what I know. That's the right code. Okay, okay. Is that all high contents? Why it didn't work? Alright, I don't have a solution why the line contents. So look at the date. The height is not set. Look. I will set the height here 200%. And then it told me that's not gonna work. Well, the height has 100%, so what's mine? What about this guy? This guy's height is 100%. Maybe that's the problem. See, this guy's height It's not 100%. That's why I have a problem. Oh God, let me let it win. Ta-da! Look at it! It's wicked and everything. Now, what I really want is to let you see that the file can be uploaded, because the Google was giving us a fake part, which we all hate, and it wasn't working. I'm going to use this image right here of a girl. I don't know if I have a girl here. Oh, the girl. I'll show you the girl. This is an African girl. I am an African. The fake part won't show here, but there's a fake part. It will show you. So I'm going to work on a fake part. So how to upload things using the binary string? The way that the string that you can use in PHP to create a file on your server, right? So how it works, I will work on it right here. So how it works is that normally, if this guy, the upload button, the input type, this guy, when he was working, we used to do, you can see the name, you can do the push, we used to do something like this, because in my next video where we will finish this, it used to be PHP. I will create a file on my server like this, and I will call it test.php, and I will get a file, because without it I cannot show you what I want to show you. I don't know where to get a file. This is images, a very tiny, the black. Look at this size, 146 bytes. That's exactly what a website. I was here, and I put the image here. Remember, this image is still on my server. I'm renaming the image. You can get any image for the experiment, small, big. Here it is. It's called BA. Now, this test, I'm gonna open it and I'll show you. In PHP, if you wanna upload something, don't forget this on my. I will show you the. Maybe you didn't have this image on a server, you had on a user, and you just want to upload it. You do this, file is equal to this. Watch this code very carefully. You see it, files, in my video, because by the time that I did that video, this thing was still working. You do the file system, and then you write the name here, like I told you. This name, this ID is targeted by JavaScript, get element by ID, whereas the name is targeted by PHP, so you see the name is file. Then you put it over there. You see the name is file, smaller thing, whatever else it is. The name is file, but I want a temporary name, because I don't want the name. The name will give you just the name, like this, ba.png, .png, alright? But the temporary name will give you the full part, like this. See, Vietnamese, to the user's computer, right? And everything that is, you know, and all of a sudden it's not working. What you do, this will have been the target for the file. In order to get the contents of the file, you will have done this file get contents, yeah, and then you get a content of the file, and the content would have looked like this. And then I will show you the content. Like this time, this thing is not working. And if you get whatever I'm going to show you, this was what we used to get when this was working, but now it's not working. So JavaScript is what the new solution is. I will use the file name that is I have put on my server. Remember, formerly this wasn't, like, the image is not official on your server, it's on the user's computer, so you would have typed the C, then, but you're not getting it, so you have to get the JavaScript. You're not even getting the file name. Before, when I did that tutorial, we're getting the file name from JavaScript and we're using it. Okay, we're getting the file system, you see the tutorial. Then later we're getting the file name from JavaScript, but now we're not getting it. So we have to upload and use this thing. So whatever we're getting from JavaScript, whatever we are going to use from JavaScript, it's like this. Or the one that they applied base 64 on it. Like it, I'll show you. So here is it. Here's how it looks like. So that when you see it, you will not scare. This is exactly what we are going to get in this tutorial. It's the same as this. It's what you're going to use to create a file. I want to show you here. I will do quickly here. You see it, and you will see. Okay, you can see the file is just, this is how it looks like, right? But it's a lot. This is just 160 of them. I don't know if it's up to 200. It's supposed to be. It's not up to 216. Okay, so this is just small because the image that I copied, it's very, very tiny. It's like a dot. This is 146 bytes. Yeah. So and each of these is 2 bytes, making it less than that's like 73 of these guys right on the screen. So that's what we're going to get with PHP. But once we get this, we can upload an image on our computer, and that I think you already know why we could. So whatever we're going to get at the end of the story is going to be like this. And if you want to know how to convert it to put it on a computer, my next video, once you see what I showed you, the file get content and the file thing, you'll be able to know that that's what we're working on. And then you're going to replace all this code, this line, with this wherever you put it. Maybe we might put it in an HTML that I will show you. Right, thank you. So I will continue the tutorial. So here we have the ability by God with the blessing to upload it using the get file. So then man, because JavaScript is gonna, like, just the JavaScript happen. So I will continue typing and continue watching too, right? I don't know if I'm boring. So we have, we're creating the function, the file. We are passing in the event because there's an event over there, and I hope I can just feels so cool. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna say var the input. The form input is equal to document, like, you know, get it in there. And we're getting this input type, and we're getting the element by the ID, like I told you, JavaScript targets the ID, and it can target all everything, but it's shorter. ID is often given. This ID is unique only to this element, but the others are not. Maybe this guy, I don't know, I'm not sure it is. So JavaScript prefers targeting this guy. Now that we have the form input, we're going to start uploading using the var file reader. We're going to say file reader is going to call file reader is equal to new file reader, right? And now that we have it, we're going to tell it file reader dot read as, this is the guy, binary string, this is the guy. We could have seen read as, okay, we're gonna say read as binary string, read as binary string, this there, this guy, what we now call form input, right? We're declaring variable. We're gonna call form, like this, form input, I think pragmatics, form input, right? Just do that. Form input. Form input files 0, right? So we're getting the files 0. This is often the first file. I don't really mess with this, guys. In case you were uploading a lot of things at the same time, you were about to upload a lot of things at the same time, because we are about to upload a lot of things at the same time. I think we are uploading it with this thing too. We're gonna say that fr.onload end, when it has loaded, load end is equal to function. Here we use an event, the event that we passed here all the way from here. This is the event. This event is unchanged, so we're passing that unchanged event all the way here. I think you already know, right? So here we go. And then we're gonna say var. Remember the string that I showed you? What I showed you normally call a string. This thing we normally call it a string. I know we call this a binary. I missed the two. The string is the basis to form. So bin is equal to something. Bin is equal to file, then it's go to the E dot target. The event, the target, that's the last function. The result, it's targeting this thing and the result of this thing, the result. Alright, and now the whole string, this string is here because we clicked on it, and then that the event was passed, and we are trying to get file, we're getting that file, and we're using the file reader. We're getting the element, and we're using the file reader on the element to get the element's files, right? And it's reading the file as a binary string. And here we are, we're going to see the same ugly thing, but I want to put it in a div so that later we can target it. Huh? You get it? I'm putting it in a Y. In an li. I don't want to put it anywhere. Look at me. I'm putting it in an li so that I can give the li a name so that I can target it in PHP. And use the string because I can target li. And if I target the li, I'll see string here. And use the string. And I will say I'll target the ID so that I can use the ID in JavaScript and put the string here. Right, so I want to use the string in PHP name. I want to put a string here. I'll put a string here in the binary data. This is the binary data. This is exactly what's in the file. Right, if I put this in the file right now, it will give me a file. Now this db.png, if I create a test file right now and I put the guy there in there, I will call it a bin. I'll call it ab.bin because there's a binary data, and I'll open it and I'll put the file here and I will save it. It will tell me to save as a Unicode. I forgot to save as Unicode. Save as dot file, save as Unicode. I think I'll save Unicode UTF-8. I forgot to want to do it. And I'll save it as dot. I'm not sure I'm sorry. Save. Yeah. Okay, I will just go, so I will rename this from bin. You can see that was the same thing I put in there. I will rename this thing from bin. I will not delete this video. I think it's PNG. Oh god. I forgot whatever it is. Now, this image works just like the one with an image. Alright. The file format cannot be open. It's an error. I should have. The browser has its own encoding, and I copied this. So this is what I got from the browser. This is not how these things look like. These are not why. The browser does not know this encoding. So that's where the error is coming from. I don't really want. But it's gonna work. I will show you in my next tutorial. So far, the li that we're gonna put in the thing, right? Li. I don't know how to call it. Li. And I will say to it, document. Sorry for dealing my time in that way. Element by ID, and it was called string. I don't know why I call it this. And I tell the string. The string, you put in the string, the inner, you put in the inner HTML or the inner text. I will put in the inner HTML, the bin, right? Remember this guy, and I will close it, and after that I will say alert. I will alert this thing. I will make you happy, right? I will make you happy. So I'll show you the image. So this is the image that we are uploading from the user's computer. We're gonna upload from it somewhere else so that you don't say, oh, this guy tried to mess up in my life. I think I'm mostly like under this. So here's the image. Wow, there's nothing in there. When I refresh it, that and then you can see the image button. There's nothing in there. This guy will have to receive a star like hitting. Display now, so that doesn't display for the user to see. But I'm putting the bin in there. I also want to put the file. You can upload it as read as data URL. You can check the spelling. It's supposed to be like this, or we're going to be in all waters. Okay, here we are. And while here, I also put in the document, whatever I did, guys. see. I am too far. Right. And here's the image is called a turkey man. Oh, sorry for the delay. I'm so sad. I didn't mean to delay you. I don't go available. I think I called it image file. I wish it was what I called image file. Now that it's here, the image is here. I'll tell it, the hey image, your SRC, it's good because an image. JavaScript allows us to target. It allows you to target a lot of things. Say image, your SRC is called to. Shit, there are two results here. Alright, I'm gonna first show you, make you happy with a binary string. I'm going to first show you binary string. So, this is the first result. Image SRC will normally have been binary. But I'm hiding that for now. Yeah, image SRC, I'm hiding this thing. We can change it. Until here, I will show you, it will be in this thing. It will be in the LI, but the LI is set to the statement, but we will still get to it. So here we are going to upload it. And so I feel like I didn't explain it. So here, we are hiding the upload button from the user because that one doesn't look good, right? But it's still on top. And we are still seeing it, right? And this guy is beneath. We can start it, but I don't have that much time. So here it is beneath, and this guy is on top it. This guy is beneath it, and this guy is on top, so they'll be able to click it and still set the opacity 0. And here we have it with the ISO 200. And here we have the get embed and get file, which is the JavaScript function here, get file. And we are just calling it on the on-chain, so that you can see that normally this guy then has a place for its hold. I don't know how to show this thing. It has a place for its hold to be shown, like where it records its nonsense. That's what you were expecting. The file name and go pick part is probably, I've not gone through such hassle. So when it changes, when that test in there, whatever is in there, whatever is coming through the element changes, it calls this function, passing the event of on-chain, the targeting event, and whatever the event led to, there's a target, and the final result of that thing, which in this case is probably at this time this guy, right? The read binary, and then we call the file reader to be able to read this guy, because the file system to really be able to read the file and see if there's indeed a file. So here we are targeting the files in it, but we are calling the first file in it. I think that's all we wanted to know sometimes. So we used to give it a lot of functions. I don't know if now it doesn't work, so that you can get a file name, the file type, it's a PNG. I think when you go to PHP, you might need it. So, we'll work on it. I think I'll look at my other tutorial and see if it's good for you to change it, or it's good, or maybe I want to change it and see why I should change it. If you want the name, normally I will talk about it. Normally we used to do dot name. Never get a name, but it was messing up since those days because it was giving us a fake path and we were using the file reader. We were just trying to get it because this can be gotten without using the file reader. We're using the file reader to get the file in it, right? Okay, so here we are reading the file's binary string because I want to work on it in the local server, on the local host, to upload it to my local host or to my web server. You also need the same thing, alright. And so but you can also read it as data URL. I don't know if you store it then in the database. This can be stored in the database, but I don't. I create a file and I store the file name right in the database, and I store the file in the server, which makes the database quite lighter and quite cleaner. And the data URL, I don't know if you break it and store it. It comes in the 64 you find later on. And then, like I said, we are targeting the LI here so that we can call it in PHP later. We can't call this guy, we can call it in PHP. But when we call it, we're not gonna get a file because what's in here is the fake path nonsense. We're not gonna get it. So when we upload it, we get a string. When we had a file name, we were able to get a string and later create a file of the string. And I mean, when we get a string, it means that's the whole file, whatever we do with it. But now, this is the whole of the file, but these are not the characters. That's why when I put it in there, it wasn't working. So now I will continue showing it to you. I feel like I'm talking plenty. So I will upload an image consists of my download page. And here we go again. Alright, so it didn't show me anything because I don't have a button. I want to hide the whole thing from the user. So you can see where I have a lot of the hidden, where I have the LI. It's my LI. Here it is. It's there, but it's hidden. And these are the files in it. This is the string. You can see how many it is. If I show it on the page, you can see that now, or you can actually get what I was trying. If I copy this and paste, I'm going to get an image. Now, this is the real binary file. This is a real character. Every guy is here. When we copy all of this, we copy all of this and put it in a file, it becomes the file itself. The only thing we'll be missing out is the file name initially, which we can get yet still, because it does give us, even that file upload give us. The file name was the one that was in there since the beginning we started this tutorial. If you do check it, you can see that it's still in there, but we don't need it because it's not giving us the path, it's just giving us the file name alone. You check it here, where it is, perplexity server. Here you can see the file in there. It starts with a lot of numbers. Most of the file, image files on my computer start with a lot of numbers. These are, not a lot of things. Oh, I forgot to refresh it. Alright, so here's the file, and we can then do it in my next video. But I want to show you this guy, the data's URL. So now I'm using that one, the data's URL, and now that they are string, it's good we can upload it to it. And now I'm encoding the image the SRC, because this time what I want to do to the bin is that it's not whatever is in, it's not a bin at all, but actually a string, because it's a base 64 string. That was why it was the most now I'm putting the string inside this image file. I was targeting here the image file, and then I'm putting inside this guy's SRC. So we paste it here as a data URL. If you don't know anything about data URLs, if you want to read, you can read. If you don't want to read, I don't think you're going to miss out on anything. You just have to look at how people are using this and use this. I'm just going to comment this guy out. And now when I run it, I hope I don't get any shocks. Boom. Boom. No shock. I want to grab a beautiful image. I'm playing for a bit. This is a world of beautiful image. Boom, here is the image. We have successfully uploaded the image. Here it is. You can see the data URL that everybody is talking about. According to sources, it was invented by Google. You see it starts with data, image, JPEG, and it starts with the nonsense code that I had that I showed you, that was a string, but just that this one is in base 64. That's why it's telling us that it's in base 64, and then the string continues. The same string that we had earlier, if I applied basis for encoding on it, it would have shown this way. I'm not sure how I can do it in JavaScript, so. But we can take this and take it to PHP. That means we have to clear all these guys off and then convert it away from base 64 before we upload it to this file. You can put all of this in your database so that you can place it right here in the SRC. It's going to make your database huge, and it's going to make it dirty, really ugly. I don't like it that way, so I decided that by God's inspiration, I create the files with on the server, and I put a file in the database. That's how it used to be in the future, until recently that a lot of things stopped working. People decided to put a binary in the database instead. I didn't do it like that. So you can watch my next video. The only thing we don't have is the file name. But hey, you're putting things on the server, a lot of files, a lot of crazy files. You don't need a file name. What you probably need is a file type, but you can get it. It's right here. Right, you can get it. If I wanted it, I will call it right here. I'll call it as the value. So file name, I'll call it right here as form input the value. Okay, I really want to split this. I should split this. So I will split on feedback, right? I think I'll split on this one since I'll go. I hope that I don't get a crush. And now I will show me, I will have to, whatever I have to do, I let this file name, I hope everything works, file name one, right? Because if it's split, it's gonna, I really hope I don't mess up. But here we go, Here we go. I hope nothing goes wrong. Not everything goes wrong. Wonderful. That's beautiful. Wonderful. The body was split. The split thing didn't work. My goodness. Oh my goodness. What am I going to do? Okay, I'll go. The split thing didn't work. Oh, bad. The body. Then I'm going to show the farm for the body. Which is, I just feel like to work. It doesn't work. Oh, you're showing me nothing. That's bad, right? But I will be able to get it for you in my next tutorial. I don't know what's wrong. I don't know what's wrong. I did. But what's wrong? Alright, bye-bye. See you next time. I don't know what's wrong with it. In that test, there's no any test. But there is no body. Okay. I didn't even, I forgot to remove the space. Maybe I'm sure that's it. Because the body works. I think it was just for my... There it is! The problem was the fake part. And I shouldn't have broken it on the, I think backslash or forward slash. This guy right here is backslash right. I should have broken it on the front. I should have broken it on this part. You can see the fake part. Normally we used to get a full part. That is, this whole thing. From Bitnami was like maybe the username better, the username Godwin, blah blah blah, complete, and then but now we're not getting it. So thank you, God is telling me more than thank you. See you later, bye bye. Watch the other one, it's called The Best Way to Upload Better Than the Blob, right? Watch it to understand it. Thank you, bye bye.